Hey everyone, this is Kirk here again at Option Alpha, and I wanted to go over in this video three of the candlestick patterns that are highly profitable for market turns. So we're going to be talking about candlestick patterns that you can find in the market that will show or give a tell that the market may be turning very, very soon. And what I like about these three patterns in particular is that they are a bit of a long pattern, meaning it's not a two candlestick pattern, it's not even a one candlestick pattern like a hammer or a shooting star. These are three together candlesticks or more that really give a good full understanding of why the market is turning at that particular time. So we're going to go through them right here, right now, and then we'll look at some visuals on current market charts so you can see them in action. So the first one is the morning doji star. This is obviously a reversal for a bullish trend. So what you actually have on this is you have a large candle that's going down representing selling or acceleration. So really, this is a three-step candlestick process. So the first one, again, is hard selling by sellers, people getting out of the stock. It looks like it's going to continue falling. The next day is the doji, which represents indecision. This means that the market open and close is fairly similar, a lot of volatility this day, and this is really showing the tug of war that's happening in the stock. So the first day we have the market falling hard. The second day is now a bit of a more indecision day, so you still don't know if it's going to reverse quite yet on the second day. That moves us to the third day, which is the long white candle, which represents buyers taking back complete control of the market. So you can see how the market sentiment has turned 100%. The first day was hard selling, the second day was a little bit of indecision or tug of war, and then the third day the buyers take this security back. So this is a good three-step candlestick pattern that can show that the market is moving off of a bottom. Now the next one that we're going to look at is the complete mirror image of the morning doji star, and that's the evening doji star. So again, everything happens in reverse. The first day is long white candle, which shows buyer acceleration. So buyers are buying the stock up, very healthy. It doesn't look like it's going to stop. The next day we have a doji that appears that's higher than the close of the long white candle. Again, this shows the indecision in the market. So buyers are less willing to buy up at these higher levels, which shows that this thing may be running out of steam. Not always, we have to wait for the third candle, but it does show that the buyers may be losing some steam. And then comes that third day, that long black candle, which means that sellers have taken back control, that the bears are now back in control of the security. And again, you can see the 180 degree turn that we've made in investor sentiment for this stock. We have buyers who are in control, then indecision, and then we have that long black day, which sellers just cram the stock down. Okay, the third one is a really, really important one. This is a good pattern for reversals, and it's the island reversal. Now, on this chart, I only show one candlestick on an island by itself, and you can see why it's called an island, because you have this gap on both sides of the trend, whether it's in an uptrend or whether it's in a downtrend. And that gap creates what's called an island of candlesticks. Now, usually you want to have an island be only 3 to 5 candlesticks at most. Once we get past 5 candlesticks on that island, it starts to really negate the strength and power of the reversal. But basically what happens in an island reversal, similar to what happens in those morning and evening stars, is that the market has huge sentiment. The market actually gaps higher. But once it gaps higher, it stays in that region and doesn't go any further. So it gets really excited and gaps higher and stays in that region, and then it loses complete faith and gaps lower. And that's what creates that island reversal. Same thing on the bottom side. The market will gap lower. It'll seem like this thing is just going to keep falling through the floor. And then the market will stabilize and actually gap again higher, showing some massive, massive buying pressure into the security. Okay, so now let's look at each of these on a stock chart just to get a look at what they look like on a real live chart. So here I am on my screen once again, and I'll go over here to my stock chart. This is a really good one that I found, and actually through the help of Thinkorswim, you can actually go up here to patterns and then click find candle patterns right here. So it's very easy to find candle patterns with Thinkorswim, and I'll go over that in another video tutorial. But here you can see that this is a morning doji star. It's a very, very clean pattern that we had on PN X back in November of last year. And again, if I zoom in on this, you can see the indecision and the hard selling that we have on the first half of this pattern. So again, hard selling. Then we have that doji where it shows indecision, or the market may be reversing here. But we need the third day, which is right here, this massive buying pressure, this long white candle here. And again, you can see this is a very good signal, because after this day, the stock ran up a little bit here. So again, very, very good, clean morning doji star. Okay, now we're going to BRKL, and this is a very good pattern of the evening doji star. Again, you can see everything happens in reverse. We have a long white day showing that buyers are still major in control here. Then we have this doji up here, which shows that buyers may be losing some steam, that this rally, which has been lasting since the low or mid eights, may be running out of steam up here in the high $10 region. Then we have the next day that has this long red candle, which is showing that sellers are taking back control of this security. Now, ideally, we'd like this red candle here to eat into or sell off just a little bit more so that it's almost even with the midpoint of the long white candle. But it is a very good signal. And again, you can see that this signal did show some selling pressure over the next 2 weeks. The last one that we're going to look at is actually Coach. And this one had a really good island top pattern back in 2007 here. This is a really good pattern again to look at. Again, like I said, 3 to 5 candlesticks on this pattern. That's usually ideal for these island tops. But you can see what happened here with Coach is that it ran up very, very strong. It got so excited that it gapped higher the next day. And so it created this gap up here on this island top. But then it traded lower throughout the island top and actually gapped lower on the 25th of September here. So it created this island of candlesticks that are all by itself. It's just out here in the open and nothing really near it. It didn't continue on from that trend. And that really creates a very strong reversal. Island tops are very strong if you can spot them in the middle of a trend here and a trend reversal. But you can see that after that island top, that coach just absolutely just got hammered. Another exhaustion gap here. Back around 40, so a very, very powerful signal that emerged on Coach.